using the BMW AeroLab for the aerodynamic development of the race cars, and it's the very same wind tunnel that's also being used for the road car colleagues.
Our target as aerodynamicists is to maximize downforce and to minimize drag.
We use computer simulation to resolve and to predict the flow field around our race car. 60% of the work is done here in front of those computers, looking at the data, and the track is really the last step to make sure that all the work we've done before lead to the correct lap time.
For me as a driver, I definitely can feel it now on track, and it's amazing to have this BMW M8 GTE with such a great performance.
The 24-hour races are the biggest challenge for the driver, the team, every mechanical part that's involved.
When we are testing and driving in the night, our main focus is on the light. The technology of the light really started from scratch with simulations. After that, the part design started, where we used also 3D printing technology. It was possible to integrate these lights already in the car and compare it with the simulation we have done.
A lot of the language in that area of the production car, we've tried to then translate into the race car, and so that's our challenge, to try to make the relationship between the production and the racing solution, but also have that recognizable design character.
We are really happy about the result which we got with our headlights and corner lights in the M8 GTE, and we think that this is the benchmark in the GTE class.
Was ganz Tolles, wenn dann zum ersten Mal so ein Rennmotor so ein bisschen anfängt zu brüllen. Er hat alle meine Erwartungen erfüllt, muss ich sagen. Und jetzt kann ich es natürlich kaum erwarten, bis das Auto das erste Mal auf die Strecke geht.
Heute ist für uns schon ungefähr Halbzeit. Die erste Hälfte war komplett virtuell. Und ab jetzt wird es real. Ab jetzt haben wir noch ungefähr 25 Wochen Zeit, wo das Auto auf der Strecke fährt, wo wir das Auto kontinuierlich verbessern, und dann ist das erste Rennen.
For the development of the car, every single test is very important. The most important for me was the endurance run, which we had in Paul Ricard, because the car is developed to run a 24-hour race, and we could finish the endurance run with a 24-hour stint.
So the special on the Daytona racetrack is we have a very high percentage of full power running here. So the stress of the engine is quite high compared to other tracks. The main target on these tests is to collect mileage with this high stress on the engine, and that we can judge is the engine prepared for a 24-hour race.
You know, when you see Mission 8 on the side of the car, everybody's treating it like a mission. And when you look at the amount of engineers and development that's gone on with the M8, there's only one target, and that's to win on Sunday at Daytona.
größten Herausforderungen zum einen waren die Effizienz des Motors. In Langstreckenrennen ist die Effizienz, ich würde sagen, ein Schlüsselfaktor für den Erfolg. Das andere war die ganze Motorsteuerung, die Bedatung. Ist eine ganz neue Herangehensweise, die wir jetzt erstmals bei diesem Projekt ausprobiert haben und uns mittlerweile schon ins Ziel geführt hat. Der Motor vom M8 GTE basiert ja großteils auf einem Serienmotor. Das heißt, das Kurbelgehäuse, Zylinderkopf werden in der Seriengießerei gefertigt, allerdings dann speziell von uns nachgearbeitet, so wie im Reglement erlaubt. Und mit diversen Bauteilen wie Kurbelwelle, Kurbeltrieb ist eine spezielle Anfertigung für uns hier angeliefert in der Werkstätte von BMW Motorsport und von unseren Werkstattspezialisten dann in Handarbeit einzeln aufgebaut. Am Prüfstand ist der P63-1, ist ein 8-Zylinder Biturbomotor für den M8 GTE. Wenn der Motor soweit läuft, dann versuchen wir Rennsituationen bzw. einzelne Rundensimulationen durchzuführen und testen jetzt das Daytona-Profil, das erste Rennen mit dem M8 GTE. Die Wahrheit ist natürlich dann immer die Strecke.
Ist mega Erfolg, nicht nur für mich, sondern vor allem für das ganze Team. Wir haben zwei Autos ins Ziel gewirkt. Das ist einfach ein Gefühl, das ist unbeschreiblich.
You guys have shown really great. Thanks really. Thank you very much.
Well, the BMW M8 GTE is designed for endurance racing. And endurance racing in the GT class, aerodynamics is very important to ensure that we can extract consistent performance.
The target on this car was really to try to build a car with very robust, very stable aerodynamic characteristics. The bodywork of the BMW M8 road car helped us a lot in achieving our aerodynamic target.
One thing that really stands out that the race car actually hits the track before the road car. So this in itself is already for us quite special and unique. Well, the BMW M8 GTE is designed for endurance racing. And endurance racing in the GT class, aerodynamics is very important to ensure that we can extract consistent performance.
The target on this car was really to try to build a car with very robust, very stable aerodynamic characteristics. The bodywork of the BMW M8 road car helped us a lot in achieving our aerodynamic target.
One thing that really stands out that the race car actually hits the track before the road car. So this in itself is already for us quite special and unique. We're using the BMW AeroLab for the aerodynamic development of the race cars, and it's the very same wind tunnel that's also being used for the road car colleagues.
Our target as aerodynamicists is to maximize downforce and to minimize drag.
We use computer simulation to resolve and to predict the flow field around our race car. 60% of the work is done here in front of those computers, looking at the data, and the track is really the last step to make sure that all the work we've done before lead to the correct lap time.
For me as a driver, I definitely can feel it now on track, and it's amazing to have this BMW M8 GTE with such a great performance.